Sunum sırasında hep mikrofonlar açık unutulunca çok gürültü geliyor. O yüzden mikrofonlar kapalı tutuluyor. Yok, sizin videolar burada gözükmüyor.
Welcome. Let's wait two more minutes, then we can start.
Okay. Dear participants, welcome to our web seminar today. We will ready to introduce you our new design three-phase battery chargers and single-phase battery chargers, rectifiers, and the battery monitoring system. What we added new functions and some new standards, Mr. Emirhan will explain us with video supported into the presentation. And if you have any question, please save it to the end of the seminar. We will answer all your questions. Yes, Mr. Emirhan, you can start.
Thank you, Mr. Ayhan. Let's get started. First of all, I want to say welcome to everyone. Thanks for your participation to our webinar. I'm Emirhan Bulut, and I'm working as sales engineer in Power Electronics. By the way, Mr. Ayhan, the project manager in our company, are also with us today. We'd like to continue our presentation interactively, and I can get your questions at the end of each topic. You may write your questions to the QA section. In this presentation, we'll also benefit from the long years of experience of Mr. Ayhan in this sector. Today, I'll give you a short company introduction and talk about our new type of rectifiers and their importance. Main topics of our presentation are TEYAŞ, Turkish Electricity Transmission Company type rectifier, which is compatible with EN60146 standards, TEDAŞ, Turkish Electricity Distribution Company type rectifier, and battery monitoring system. These are the main topics of our presentation. So as you can see, there is not too many topics. Therefore, we'll talk about the importance and differences of the products by touching on the technical details. In this way, we'll briefly mention what kind of solutions our company can produce apart from our standard products. Now let's briefly talk about our company. Power Group consists of three companies. These companies are Power Electronic, Power Solar, and Power Engineering. Power Electronic operates and doing business in the production and sales of power electronic equipment. And Power Solar carries out project planning, commissioning, maintenance activities in solar energy sector. On the other hand, Power Engineering provides added value to our company by creating special designs for companies in lots of special projects. Power Electronic was established in 1999. Since the day it was founded, it's aimed to create innovation in its sector and introduce quality products. While continuing to produce and sell in Turkey, we also export to more than 40 countries. Our product range consists of UPS, rectifier, inverter, converter, regulator, car chargers, and also special products for special applications. The achievements can be summarized as follows: 22 successful years in the sector, more than 10,000 customers, more than 5 big projects, 70 employees, 45 dealers worldwide, 10 memberships, 6 brand agencies, 13 quality certificates. Human resources is the most important factor for a company. Most of our employees are highly experienced, and also monthly trainings are organized for our new employees. Thanks to the technical trainings organized, it's ensured that all our employees are aware of the current technical developments. 15 people are working in our R&D department. Our engineers here carry out design and software activities as well as prototype and testing work. These are our ongoing R&D projects. These projects are almost finished. After testing and acceptance of these devices, mass production will begin. Switch mode rectifier is able to operate in wide input voltage range. The power factor is also high, as you can see. Inverter has a very low harmonic value and can be paralleled up to 10 pieces and up to 100 kVA power. If we talk about static regulator, input voltage range is very wide. It's especially important that it can provide stable output even at 65 volts input. So electricity car charger, in this regard, the production and sales of AC car charger have been completed. Besides, our design and software activities for DC devices continue at full speed. Here you see two different car charger designs. These are devices that are currently in production. Production started 1 year ago. Development work still continues. These devices can be preferred as freestanding wall or wall-mounted devices. Its technical features are as follows. Single phase 3.7 or 7.4 kilowatt, three phase 11, 22, 43 kilowatt models are available. Also, RFID communication can be provided as an option. RFID is preferred for commercial use. By the way, advantages of this charger are as follows: reasonable price, modularity, and easy assembly. Here are screenshots of our mobile and web application. Thanks to these applications, the surrounding stations can be seen. In addition, the charging status of the vehicle can be seen. What you see on the screen right now are the R&D certificates of our company. And these are given by the Ministry of Technology, and that shows regular R&D studies are continuing in our company. And these are our quality certificates. These certificates are requested especially in important projects. Our products have also been tested and approved in this regard. As you can see, there are too many certificates, both in valid in world and in also in Turkey. As you know, when purchasing a product in the electronics sector, the support period and competence of the technical service of the company are taken into consideration. In this regard, I should state that we are at a good level in customer happiness, thanks to our competent team. And also we are doing our best to increase that. Now I'd like to briefly tell you about our Power Solar company and the work they do. This company, a part of our group company, continues its activities with a focus on renewable energy and also cares about making positive contributions to the future of our planet. For this purpose, product choices are made to maximize energy efficiency and minimize carbon footprint. I'm going to show you now some of our completed solar projects. We have many applications both on roof and on the ground. Besides, we have many more completed projects, and also we have some ongoing projects. 2.2 megawatt power solar project and 3.2 megawatt 2 megawatt power solar project and 10.7 megawatt solar project. These are just some examples. Speaking of renewable energy, we should also mention our energy storage units. In recent years, renewable energy sources have been rising rapidly and are replacing other sources. However, in solar and wind systems, energy is produced at only certain times, so they need a complementary technology. This is why the need for energy storage has gained importance recently. At this point, we can produce solutions. We provide these solutions with long duration storage units that reach a capacity of up to 5 gigawatt hours. Thus, the most important shortcoming of renewable energy is completed. You can also see in this photo the future of energy production and consumption. Wind and solar systems that produce energy and long duration energy storage units. Now I will tell you about our industrial rectifier. As you know, rectifiers are also called DC UPS. In case of any interruption in the network, the DC load will be fed by the batteries. This device you have seen in your screen is our industrial solution. These devices are especially needed in transformer substations. In addition, these devices are also important in all facilities where DC loads need to be fed uninterrupted and cleanly. The biggest advantages we provide to our customers are robustness and the ability to produce according to the desired current and voltage values. Since we work with many national and international organizations, these products have the necessary certificates, especially since all the technical values requested by the electricity transmission and distribution companies are very important, most of our designs have been completed considering these requests. Besides, these devices are compatible with lead acid batteries and also nickel cadmium batteries. Designs can be made up to IP54. Thanks to the advanced battery charge management, the healthy operation of the batteries is ensured also. The device you see right now is our industrial rectifier and the layout of the equipment. If you look here, you can see that it consists of many components such as thyristors, diodes, fans, as well as parts such as isolation transformers and connection terminals. This rectifier has 220 volt DC, 222 amps output. It can meet approximately 48 kilowatt power. We have already manufactured this product and many other high power products. As I said before, these rectifiers are also called DC UPS. In some very critical applications, these devices are required to be parallel just like AC UPS. When a parallel system is installed, rectifiers share the output current regularly while both devices work without any problems. And if any problem happens in any device, the other device will feed the load longly. Now, first subject of our technical webinar. Now, I will talk about our TEAŞ, Turkish Electricity Transmission Company type rectifier, which we have made a new design with changes. These devices are generally preferred as three phases. These are 48, 110 to 220 volt DC options at the output. In addition, devices with 30, 60, 80, 100, 120 amps output are produced in standard. Apart from this, we can produce devices that provide much higher power for special demands. Communication is provided with 16 dry contacts as standard. In addition, optionally, Modbus TCP and Modbus RTU are also available. Now let's talk about the front view of our device. You see the LCD screen MIMIC diagram in simplified form. Status and warning LEDs also you can see. There is also an analyzer here. This analyzer is also our own design. I would like to briefly explain the working logic of rectifier. While the mains is present, the mains voltage is converted to DC voltage by rectifier. This DC voltage both feeds the load and charges the batteries also. However, if the mains is cut off, the battery continues to feed the load thanks to the energy it has stored. Thus, no interruptions occur. Now I will explain the dropper system. In some cases, it may be necessary to charge batteries in high voltage. While charging the batteries at high voltage, it's undesirable for the load to be affected by this high voltage. Here the dropper units comes into play. Here, for example, there is a battery charging voltage 132. 132 is applied to batteries, but this voltage is reduced by the dropper system and reflected to the output as 110 volts. Now let's look at the dropper unit when the device is running in battery mode. The dropper unit doesn't work in battery mode. Whatever the voltage of the battery is, that battery voltage is transferred to the load. Now, this is what I will say about these rectifiers. Now, let's move on to the video explanation of our product, which is in accordance with Turkish Electricity Transmission Company certification, which is also compatible with EN 60100 for 46 standards. Now I will tell you about the new design of our rectifier. In accordance with TEYAŞ, Turkish Electricity Transmission Company specification. First of all, there are connection points on the top for ease of transportation. At the same time, the device will be sent to you with a pallet on the bottom. Having doors on the front and back provides ease of access. There is a lock on the front cover to prevent access by unauthorized persons. The key is also sent to our customers on the device. There are information labels on the front of the device. On this side, we have our caution labels, our OK labels indicating that the device has passed our two separate tests, and our label on the lower side that tells us what to pay attention to when using it. When we open our front cover, it's possible to interfere with the device. Here you can see 16 status warning and error LEDs. These LEDs show the main status, whether the DC output is high or low, whether there is DC leakage in the device, temperature and current limit warnings. There is a control panel and mimic diagram under the status LEDs. You also see the LCD screen. There are control buttons under the LCD screen, and there is a measuring instrument under the buttons. With this measuring instrument, we can read two voltage information and two current information, load current and voltage, battery current and voltage. There is a capacitor charging button just below the meter. In normal charging, our device has a soft start feature. However, when there is no mains, we use this button when we are going to energize it over the battery. Below are surge arrestors, input fuses, battery fuse, and output fuse. There are also lamp, heater, and fan fuses. At the end, there is a DC surge arrestor. You can also find documents such as the user manual and test report on the front cover of the device. When the second cover is opened, the electronic part of the device is accessed. There are input and output terminals at the bottom of the fuses. You can make the cable inlets and outlets of the device from the bottom of the device. There are also dry contact terminals here. There are 16 dry contact information as standard. In order to energize the device, first of all, cable connections must be made. Then we bring the input fuse to the on position. The device turns on. It stabilizes when it reaches 120 volts. As you can see, the input fuse doesn't fail, but the battery and output fuse are in the off position, so their LEDs are on. Also above, then the fan lamp fuse, battery fuse and output fuse are turned on. There is no error LED, only the mains is on and the start LED is on. When there is any error in the device, it will be seen on the top line of the LCD screen. Below it's the battery charging voltage, load voltage, output current, and at the bottom is the battery charging current. On the right side, VR, VS, VT values are voltage values per phase. The IR, IS, IT values below are the current values per phase. Below it's frequency information. Below are the STA values. There are three NTC temperature sensors inside the device. T transformer temperature, S cooler temperature, A battery temperature. The battery is sent outside the NTC. You can use it by mounting it on the batteries. Z indicates time. Currently, the device has been running for 5 minutes. Now, let's examine the DC analyzer developed by our R&D department within the scope of the project. We can make 4 measurements with a single analyzer. 2 DC voltage and 2 current measurements can be made. Here you can see the measurements of the battery side, and here you can see the measurements of the load and total current. For example, this is the voltage and this is the total current. Currently on the battery side, you can see the battery voltage and battery charging current. These transitions are made automatically every 10 seconds. If you want, you can make these transitions yourself with the buttons. In the previous design, 4 measurements were taken with 4 measurement instruments. But at the moment, we can take all 4 measurements with a single analyzer. It works with 1% error rate. Now let's test the rectifier at different current values. The battery charging current is 0.8 amps and the total output current is about 5 amps. Now we connect a new load to the device and the total load current of the rectifier is currently about 16.8 and 0.8 ampere of this current is the charging current drawn by the battery. Now we are increasing the load. Now the total current is around 20.7 amps. By the battery is 0.8 amps. We are increasing the load. As you can see now, the rectifier current limit LED is on. The total current now doesn't exceed 30 amps. The battery current is negative, as you can see. So the battery is discharged. The current drawn by the load is greater than the capacity of the rectifier. The load currently draws about 31 amps of current. Now let's check the system with an ampere meter. The total current drawn by the load is 31 amps. We are providing another load right now. The total current drawn at this time has exceeded 40 amps. But as you can see, the rectifier limits itself around 30 amps. As can be seen here, the current drawn from the battery is approximately 9 amps. The load has been slightly reduced. The currents are now approximately equal. Battery current is 0, total current is 30. We reduced the load a little more and the total load went below the limit. The battery started to charge. It draws about 7 amps of charging current. We reduced the load a little bit more. The total current is around 13 amps. At this time, if the mains goes out, the LEDs will turn on, indicating the mains is gone, the rectifier has stopped, and there is an error. In addition, we can see in the mimic diagram that the input fuse is in the off position. If the mains returns, the device continues to work automatically. It continues to feed the load over the batteries even where there is no mains. Now let's test our dropper feature with you. What are dropper units used for? Batteries are discharged periodically and it recharge at high voltage and high current. This high voltage can reach up to 140 volts. While the batteries are being charged at this voltage, this high voltage shouldn't be reflected to the load. This is where the dropper units come into play. If the charge voltage rises above the set dropper voltage, the dropper units are activated and adjust the load voltage by reducing the charge voltage at a certain stage. Let's give an example now. We stopped again. As you can see, it's currently on normal charging. We'll put the device in fast charging mode and charge the batteries at 132 volts. In the dropper settings, we see that the first stage of the dropper is 126.5 volts and the second stage is 137.5 volts. Now let's test the first stage. First, we exit the menu and start the device. Here the fast charging LED is active. As you can see, the load voltage is 118 volts. Although the charge voltage is 132 volts. So 132 volts is not reflected to the load side and the load is protected. After the rectifiers come out of the production line, they are first visually checked, then security tests, then functional tests, and load tests are done. Before shipment, final checks are made and the products are sent to the customers. We'll now examine the two phases of our security testing with you. Insulation tests and ground continuity tests. First, we'll do an insulation test. The insulation test consists of three stages. In the first stage, we apply 2000 volts between the AC input of the device and the chassis of the device. In the second stage, between the DC output of the device and its chassis. And in the last stage, between the input and the output of the device. Here you can see the 2000 volt value. And the maximum amount of current we can see is 5 milliamperes. If it exceeds 5 milliamperes, it's considered to have not passed the insulation test because it's harmful to human health. Surge arrestor is deactivated during insulation test. The first probe is connected to the metal part of the device, and the second probe is connected to the input AC part. And we start the test. It reaches 2000 volt in 10 seconds. It's around 1.94 milliamps as a result. In other words, the first stage of the insulation test was successfully passed. Second stage. The first probe is connected to the metal part of the device and the second probe is connected to the output DC part. We waited 10 seconds. And as you can see, it's about 3 milliamps. In step 3, we arrange the connection. We connect the first probe to the input of the device and the second probe to the output of the device and start the test. As you can see, it's about 3.14 milliamps. The device has successfully passed the isolation test. We'll now do ground continuity test.
For ground continuity test, the first probe is connected to the bottom of the device and the other probe is connected to the top of the device. 10 amps of power is applied to the rectifier for 10 seconds. It's planned to have a maximum resistance of 100 milliohms. Now we start the test. As you can see, it's around 15 milliohms. After the 10 second test period was over, the device gave us approval and our device also passed the ground continuity test.
Şu an I hope you liked the video. Now I will tell about our TEDAŞ, Turkish Electricity Distribution Company type rectifier, which we have made a new design with changes. Usually, the input is single in these devices. At the output, 24 volts, 48 volts, 110 volts, and 220 volt options are available also in this device. In terms of output current, we can produce between 5 and 120 amps. Power factor is 0.9. Communication is provided with 8 dry contacts. Optionally, Modbus RTU and Modbus TCP options are available also in this device. It has also the discharge protection. In other words, while the device is operating in battery mode, the voltage will continue to decrease. As an example, the standard battery voltage for 24 volt rectifier is 26 volts. It will drop to 20 volts or even lower values while feeding the load. But thanks to the discharge protection, it's prevented from falling below a certain value. When it falls below this value, the output will be turned off and waits for the mains to arrive. In this way, the health of the battery will be protected. Now I'll show you a short video about this rectifier, but this video will be shorter than the other video. Açıyorum.
Now I will explain the rectifier that we produced in accordance. Now I will explain the rectifier that we produced in accordance with TEDAŞ, Turkish Electricity Distribution Company specification. We see that device is screwed from the sides and front in accordance with the specification. In case of malfunction, it's possible to intervene in the device by removing these screws. The rectifier comes on a pallet for ease of transport. You can make cable connections from the left or right side of the device. You can see 16 pieces, status and warning LEDs on the front of the device. Here you can see if mains is present, whether mains is high, DC voltage is high or low, DC leakage status, rectifier current limit, fan fault, over temperature, battery fault and general fault status. The device goes through two separate tests after the assembly process, and OK labels are attached after these tests. Below is the mimic diagram. In this diagram, we see the fuse state. There is a control panel next to it and information labels next to it. Below is the fuse cover. Operating instructions are available here also. When we open the cover, we can access the fuses. Input fuses, battery fuses, output fuses, AC, DC, surge arresters. There are caution warnings and operating instructions under the fuses. When we open the cover, we see input terminals, dry contact terminals, and output terminals. On the left side of the cover, there are information labels of the terminals. There are 8 dry contacts as standard. Optionally, Modbus RTU communication can be added. The battery cabinet has drawers. Service or battery replacement can be done easily by removing the drawer. We made the rectifier input and output connections. Input and load cables. Terminal connections are made here. Input fuse is turned on. Voltage is rising slowly. In the mimic diagram, the LED is off because the input fuse is in the on position. But battery and load fuses are in the off position, so their LED is on. As you can see, the voltage is now 27 volts. We turn the battery fuse to on position. Battery fuse LED turned off. Since the load fuse is in the off position, its LED continues to light. At the same time, the general error LED is also on. Now the current is slowly increasing as seen on the screen. V0 is the charge voltage, VL is the load voltage, I0 is the load current, IB is the battery charging current. On the right side are the input voltage, input current, input frequency, date and time information, temperature information, thanks to NTC sensors, you can see these temperatures. Now we turn on the DC output fuses. We currently have a load of about 6 amps on the system. As you can see now, there are no errors left. In the mimic diagram, or alarm LEDs are turned off. Now let's do the tests at different current values. We increase the load. As you can see, the total current is around 17 amps. And 2.5 amps of this total load is battery charging current. We are increasing the load again. Total current is 25 amps. 2 amps is the battery charging current. currently 25 amps. That is the limit value. If we increase the load a little bit more, some of the load current will be supplied through the battery. We increase the load. As you can see, the rectifier current limit warning and general error LEDs are on. Currently, about 2 amps of current is drawn from the battery. The total power of the device is limited to around 25 amps. The total current drawn by the load is around 27 amps. Here, the current limiting feature of the rectifier was tested. Now we reduce the load. The battery had just been discharged. Now it started to charging again. Now let's take a look at the power outage situation. We turn off the input fuse, the LED indicating that there is no mains turned on. Also, the general error LED turned on. In the mimic diagram, the input fuse LED is on. And the current drawn by the battery is 15 amps. In other words, only the battery currently meets the load demanded by the system. Now let's turn the input fuse back to on position. The LEDs showing the presence of the network and the operation of the device turned on again. Now the device will take over the load again.
I hope you like this video also. And we move on to the battery monitoring system, which is the last topic of our presentation. Here we need to point out that we offer all battery times that you see on your screens. Together with our products for our customers, at the same time, we have made it our duty to make them work in healthy way. In addition, we are the distributor of BAE battery company. Products of BAE company, stationary batteries, photovoltaic batteries, tractional batteries, and railway batteries. This company sells its batteries worldwide for use in power applications, including photovoltaic, telecommunication systems, electrical utilities, railways, uninterruptible power supplies, and forklift also. So as a distributor of this company, we can provide all these products to our customers. You see a graph on this page. This graphic shows the approximate failure rates in devices such as UPS and rectifiers that work compactly with batteries. As you can see, the faults caused by the batteries have the highest rate here. Approximately 1/3 of the faults in this kind of electronical devices consist of battery faults. Why batteries fail? This is an important question. Some possible failure causes can be listed like that. The internal temperature of battery is high or low. Total charge voltage on the batteries is abnormal. The charge and discharge currents are abnormal. The charging mode is not suitable for the battery. The temperature of room is out of the ideal range. We can say that these are the most basic causes of failure. You see now the architecture of battery monitoring system on your screens. When you look at that, there are many sensors and control modules. Measurements are made on each individual batteries and on main cables, which the battery sit ring is connected. In this way, very detailed system monitoring can be achieved. Now I will show you a short video about battery monitoring system. If you pay attention here, you can see that the monitoring system is installed on 5 batteries. Some give red signals. This indicates that there is malfunction in these batteries, which shows red signal. And these batteries should be replaced. Yellow ones are also warnings and should be checked. If the batteries are in normal condition, the light will be green. Now you see the battery monitoring software on your screens. With this software, you can monitor the status of your batteries anytime and anywhere. You can view the status of your batteries from both on the computer and on your phone. What are we measuring with battery monitoring systems? Thanks to the measuring unit on each battery, we measure the voltage, internal resistances and temperatures of each battery separately. In addition, the string voltage and string current are measured by the modules on the main cables of the strings. And also thanks to this system, the ambient temperature is controlled all the time. On this page, you can see some of our references. It's not possible to describe all of them one by one, but thanks to our experience in this sector for many years, we have completed lots of big projects with many companies like this. To summarize this presentation today, we talked about the new design and developments in our battery chargers and also our company's importance in energy sector with high technology products. Thank you very much for listening. I hope it was useful for all of you. We talked about many products. I think we can call this webinar as a small training. We are doing this kind of webinars every month, and so you are all invited to all these webinars. You can follow us on web for the following webinars. If you have any questions, you can ask them ask these questions, and or you can contact us for or all your questions by phone or email. No problem. We will try to reply your all your questions. Mr. Ayhan, you want to add something?
Yes, thank you, Mr. Emirhan. I just would like to
Your voice is not here.
Okay. Now is it okay? Is it okay now?
Mr. Ayhan, we cannot hear you.
Is it okay now? Okay, somebody hear me.
Now we can hear.
I just would like to tell something about our battery charger design. We explained it based on our Turkish TEİAŞ electricity distribution transmission company and TEDAŞ electrical distribution company, but our designs done by according to the international IEC standard, and you can use these products all in the international projects all over in the world. Projects already we are providing these units to the projects in the Middle East, in Asia, in Europe, in African countries projects. And as I told you, all design is based on the international standards. Do you have any other questions? I just read that somebody need the video copy of the seminars. If you write email to to us, we can send you the link of the video. And also, if you follow our YouTube channel, Power Electronic, so that you can watch from the YouTube channel also. Yes. Any other question? Emirhan Bey, sizi duyamıyoruz.
I guess no one has any other questions, Mr. Ayan.
Okay, so thank you very much. Thank you for your time you spent for us. And please keep in touch and follow us. We will organize new seminars about our products and some new designs.
Okay. Thanks again for everyone for your participations. I'm ending the webinar here. Have a nice day.
Okay, just a moment. Do you have any solution for Dubai? We already provided these battery chargers to Dubai for some projects, and there is no problem. Our products already since last 5 years, we are working with some companies in Dubai. Actually, I am not informed by the project because our agent just sold to the end users, and I don't know end users' projects details. But we are already participating to the Dubai Middle East exhibition, and if you follow us, you can visit us in the exhibition, our stand. We will share our stand informations when it is clarified. It is, I think, 1st of the March. Okay, then we can talk also face-to-face on the exhibition. Okay, thank you.
Okay, Mr. Ayan, can we finish?
Yes.
Okay, take care. Have a nice day, everyone. Thanks for your participation.
Bye-bye.